I am going to show you how to make the best pizza you've ever had, and it's vegan. It's very, very healthy. It's one of the healthiest pizzas you will have, too. I mean, there's no dairy, there's no gluten. Oh, you are going to love this pizza. Oh, my God, it's so good. It's so good. Okay, you'll need pizza crust, marinara sauce, cheese, vegan here, meatballs, vegan here, squash, garlic, onions, tomatoes, and basil. Trader Joe's cauliflower pizza crust said to bake it for like 10 minutes on one side. Okay, so a lot of preparation goes into this. It's not just baking a frozen pizza. It's better than that. Instead of topping the pizza with a lot of processed fake cheese, I prefer to steam summer squash and sneak it under the cheese, and it tastes like cheese, but it's healthier. So if you want to do that, cut up some squash and steam it. Okay, so we cooked one side of the pizza crust for 10 minutes, so let's flip it over. I don't bake the meatball pizza topping. I prefer to saute these meatballs separately. I love these Gardein brand meatless meatballs. These are incredible. And what I like to do is I like to cut them in half and brown them. These come 13, so I usually take 6 1/2 and I saute them. Yeah, then I like to brown both sides. These are $4 a bag, but we're just using $2 worth today, and I am going to have two meals from this, so it's just $1 a meal on these meatballs. Slice some tomato so we can have tomato as one of the toppings. I love that. I also want to top with onion, so let's cut some of that up. All right. And let's brown the onion. So we'll put the meatballs and the onion on top of the cooked pizza, because I prefer the flavor of them being sauteed than just cooked, baked. Okay, let's see. All right, you can see this is almost cooked. So let's dress this up, shall we? All right, let's add a lot of garlic right on the crust. The crust is mostly baked, but we're gonna bake it a little more. Actually, what I'm putting on it now doesn't really have to be baked. This raw garlic is great, as is tomatoes. What I like to do that I've never seen anybody else do, but it's a great way to eat your squash, is I put squash under the fake vegan cheese, because what that does is it like thickens the cheese. You don't really taste the squash. You'll taste the cheese, and the squash is healthier than the cheese, but you won't even know what's there. You won't know what's there. Actually, you could serve this to somebody and they would just think it's, oh, it's really thick cheese. Okay, so we got the squash on it. Now here's some fake cheese, but it's good. And even though it's good, I try to stay away from products with a lot of ingredients. I try to eat the healthiest that I can eat, and that'll be enough. That'll be enough to give that, yep, certainly smells like cheese. Cheesy flavor. Okay, now we're going to go over with the tomatoes. And let's add a little sauce to it. Just some red sauce. I like Trader Joe's marinara sauce, because they have less sugar in this than other brands. I can't find a brand without sugar, but this one has less. Okay, we cooked it about 10 more minutes on 450 degrees. Look at that, huh? Damn, that looks fantastic, right? That's looking good. The meatballs and the onions really only take about 5, it could be 10 minutes to saute. Look at that, man. Look at that. How incredible is that? And why not add some fresh basil from my indoor garden? Look at that, man. Look at that. How incredible is that? And let's add the fresh basil. All right. There it is. There's this beautiful, incredible vegan pizza. Look at that. Oh my God, that is so good. You know what? You can add the cheese on top of the tomato sauce, and it'll look more like a cheesy pizza that way. All right. Look at that, huh? Everything. I can taste the cauliflower crust, and the meatballs taste just like real meat. Oh my God. The squash looks like real cheese, and it tastes a little like cheese. I mean, you wouldn't know it's squash. You guys, this is the best, healthiest pizza you can ever get. Oh,